Alrighty, welcome to the second part of my lovely Wizard 101 Let's Play. Nothing has changed. I still have my gorgeous looking characters over here and lovely level 5. Alright, so currently we have to go to Old Town. I believe there's a new part of the game. Like, there was an old boss you had to fight, and now I think there's a new. Oh, goodness. Oh, goodness. Get me out of here. Okay. Maybe I should have checked the realm before I hopped on. Alright. To Old Town we go. Alright, so I have no clue which street I want to start with. I'm pretty sure I'm going to do Triton Avenue because that is the free-to-play street.
Beware! Beyond these gates, the city's gone mad. Wait, you're the hero of Unicorn Way. The headmaster sent you to help? Thank goodness. We've got undead all over the place. Every cursed spirit and vile ghost we sealed away has broken free and attacked the city. Nowhere is safe.
Ooh, pets. This is the
Now
new
what?
part.
Oh. Well, it's a pet. But it shouldn't be in that tower. That's the caretaker's tower. Nobody's been in there since old Judd, the keeper of the cemetery, passed. Oh, right. Undead. Wizard, go with the pet. Work together and find out what's happening in that tower.
So this is the new boss. So it used to be
You now have
Falgaze?
a pet egg in your inventory. Once it hatches, you can equip the pet just as you would a wand and bring it into the tower.
Oh, that's so cute. Aw, I kind of like it.
Wizard, hurry! You have to help!
You shouldn't have come to this tower. No, shouldn't have done that. Gonna interfere with things don't concern you.
Yo, as much as that voice should creep me out, it kind of reminds me of all the villains from Scooby-Doo.
Like my plan to turn all pets into zombie pets, I'll. You'll see you will. When it comes to pets, sometimes undead is better.
If you have
Kinda
a pet
hot.
equipped, it can help you in battle.
Alright, let's fight this man. I don't even remember what my deck setup is. Only 150 health? Yo, I can kill him. Oh, I have too many pixies in here. Okay. I can kill him with one ghoul. He myth shielded, and I'm gonna hit him with the ghoul and knock this man's out. I love the Thunder Snake animation. Look, I'm killing him with himself. Just recolored. Quirky.
I know when I'm warped, but I threw the key to my pet kennel into the kennel itself, I did. You can't get through those bars, nohow.
What? That's terrible!
I
We
hate Penny
have to get
Dreadful.
into that kennel. But how? Huh? Oh, I'm Penny Dreadful. I'm new here. What are
No,
you?
I don't know.
You are now commanding your pet, allowing you to get to places and see things wizards
Yo, can I
can't.
bite her?
Use
Can I
this
bite her?
ability to
Can I
enter
bite
the
her?
next room.
Oh my god, Penny Dreadful. I remember when I did like all of the like completions of this. Like I did a completionist of all the quests, and her side quests are just so annoying. They're the most obnoxious thing. Yo, can this man's go any faster? He is so slow, but he's kind of cute. I like the little serpent. It's kind of cute. All right. Ew.
Now that you're pet.
Great! Now let's go save all those poor pets!
Yay! I bet you there's something else we have to do up here.
Ah, these cells have combination locks, and only old Judd would know the code. I mean, maybe the captive pet saw him put. Maybe we can guess the combo.
Let's see.
00001. Nope, not it. 00002. Not our only sensible option is to find some way to talk to these captive pets and get the combo.
Perfect. Perfect.
Yep, I saw that smelly guy put in the combo lots of times. It's 000003.
Yo, why is this fire cat, like, European? Like, I'm so confused.
Meow.
That's cute. Alright, Penny Dreadful.
Don't worry. I'll make sure the pets get back to the pet pavilion in one piece. Check it out sometime. After they're safe, I'll go to the headmaster. For right now, though, go tell the guard outside what's happened here.
Oh my gosh, I'm never talking to Penny Dreadful again unless I have to. Mm-mm. Don't like that chickie. Don't like her voice. It's shrill. That's just my own personal bias, though. Alright.
You saved the pets and a young student? Not bad, but our work is just beginning and I need all the help I can get.
Speaking of which, you're with this talent.
I've got alarming reports from Cyclops Lane and Triton Avenue, and I haven't heard anything out of Firecat Alley. So, where do you want to start?
Alright, here we go. Not bad.
Triton Avenue's being overrun by the undead. I don't have any guards left to try and deal with it either. You're not the first student to offer help. Two wizards named Griffinbane went in a little while ago, and there was another named Grimwater. But none of them have come out, and I've gotten no word. Can you help me try to find them? Good luck, and above all, be careful.
All right. Here we go. We're speedrunning Triton Avenue today. Let's go. Let me quickly... I don't need this. Alright. So they changed the storyline here a little bit.
You there! Help!
So, it used
to... Look there, wizard! Do you see that? It's a teleporter. If you use it, it will transport you to other teleporters on...
I'm lucky you came along.
I like his voice actor, oh my.
Something has broken the flow of storm magic through the street. Those towers should have arcs of lightning between them. My sister Susie and I came to see if we could help get things back under control, but we got separated. The haunted minions drove me back.
Yo, the haunted minions have like 2 health.
Can you create a diversion so I can try to break through, attack the minions, and I'll meet you by the river?
Okay, great. All right. We've got this. So basically, they changed the plot, and it used to be where you saved saved Arthur, and you talked to Susie. But now it's the other way around, and gonna be honest, I don't know why they changed it. I don't know what made them think, oh, we should have them save Susie instead. But I do like how they've structured the plot and, like, the lore of Triton Avenue now. Woohoo! Alright. Let me get another haunted minion. See what we can do here. Okay, so now that we have finished fighting those guys, we get to talk
Thanks
to Arthur.
Thanks for the help, wizard. I wouldn't have gotten here without you. I'm worried something terrible has happened. On my way here, I saw one of the lightning eels with Susie's wand in its jaws. Maybe she just dropped it, but maybe not.
Probably
what
not.
What can we do?
I couldn't help it over here. You're very loud. If you can bring me that wand, I may be able to assist.
I also had the fattest crush on this character when
really?
I was a child.
How?
Duncan Grimwater, necromancer. I was drawn here by a massive surge of death magic. It must be the reason the undead have overrun the street. I wish Malastair were here. He could stop all this madness instantly. If only he were still alive. Malastair is alive? Impossible. I don't know what you saw, but you must be mistaken. Someone is trying to deceive you and Professor Ambrose.
See?
Malastair was a great man, the greatest necromancer of this age. Ambrose is responsible for what happened to him. If he hadn't...
Can we talk about this later? My sister's lost out there.
You're right. Wizard, bring me that wand, and I think I can get to the bottom of this.
Oh, that's cute. Oh, that's so... Oh, I love how they actually gave them, personalities. Because Duncan used to actually, just be a jerk. But now he actually has, beliefs and a personality. Which I kind of enjoy. Even though he's still just a jerk. I'm gonna just blade hit with a fire elf. First fire elf of the walkthrough. Alright, the electric eels are also brand new to the game. It used to just be hunted minions that walked all around this area. And you don't really have a reason to go around over here. So now there's actually a reason, because you have the electric eels. You used to pick up Arthur's wand from the entrance to the haunted cave, I think is what it's called. But I guess they didn't want you walking all the way down there, because it is a bit of a hike. And by this point, most people's one-day mounts had worn off or anything like that. So.
Excellent. Susie is still alive. I can sense it from her wand. I think I can find her, but there's one more thing I need. I know a ritual that could grant me a vision of wherever Susie is. It's very advanced. I'm not surprised you don't know it.
That was a bit shady.
The connection between Susie and her wand is one anchor for the ritual, but I need another, and I think I know what will work. When I was trying to reach the source of the death magic, I ran afoul of the rotting fodder across the river. They're using storm magic.
That doesn't make any sense. Why are they using storm magic instead of death?
They were wearing strange amulets that were crackling with storm energy. Bring me those amulets and I can cast my spell.
Oh, I'm really excited that this stayed in the plot. The whole... the dead using storm magic. Oh, I loved this aspect. Alright. Also, the teleporters are kind of quirky and fun. Alright, rotting fodder time. I love their updated models. I like their little top hats. I'll just pass. Alright. Let's hit him with himself. I love the aspect of these guys being storm and having that be a really big thing as to why it drew in the storm and death wizards. Right? Because otherwise that doesn't necessarily make sense. Three of them? Alright. I will be back once I have defeated all three. Alright, so I have now finished the lovely defeat and collect, because we love a good defeat and collect. I believe they upped that to 100% collect, because it used to be that you had a chance of not collecting, and that would take forever.
Now, let's see what I can see. If I'm right, and I usually am, whoever's enchanting these storm amulets also kidnapped Susie. They probably have Susie imprisoned close by.
No duh.
I can use the link between the wand and Susie to find her, and the link between the storm amulets and their maker to produce a vision. Here goes. Nothing. Whoever this is, they have some powerful magic.
I think I could
break through the interference with a charged lumina crystal.
Mm-hmm. They make lumina crystals at the mill across the river. Go talk to Blad Raveneye and get us a crystal.
Ah, yes. This hasn't changed. A Lumina Crystal run. What level am I? Did I level up this? Oh my god, I did. Oh nice. I'm about halfway to level 7. How quirky of me.
A Lumina Crystal? You're out of luck. The undead stole all my crystals. I've got lots of raw crystal. I could grind you another one, but the mill's broken. Undead stole the wheel cogs and scattered them all over. But even if I could grind you a crystal, I couldn't charge it. My lightning rod won't work. A Scarlet Screamer stole the primary coil. You could help get me up and running again. Gather up the cogs and get my coil back from the Scarlet Screamers, and I'll get you a crystal.
All right. More defeat and collects. All right. All right. My goal is to at least leave in the first battle with like every new mob we come across. And then if we have to defeat and collect more, just cut it out. Because you don't need to see me fight probably more than 3 Scarlet Screamers. It's very unnecessary. They scream very loud, as says the name. Here we go. I think this is our first rank 2 mob we've come across. I still can't get over that you get the blade at level 5. It's so insane. I hate Scarlet Screamers. I hate them. This like brings up trauma from my youth, because they would kill me. Like I could, for some reason, just never defeat them. So I'd have to fight them like 50 billion times. Dude, I hate that these spells can hit so hard. Right, health, health, health. Alright, I will be back once I've collected 2 more. Alright, well, that is the final Scarlet Screamer done. I am severely low on mana. I forget how quickly you lose mana in the earlier levels, because it's not even something I worry about later on. Oh my goodness, do I worry about it here. It's got a good sound.
Splendid. Now, put those cogs to good use and get the old wheel turning. I'll fix the lightning rod.
Alright, here we go. Let's get this baddie.
We're ready. Here, just pull this lever and we'll charge that Lumina Crystal right up.
Where's the lever?
Ah, well done, wizard.
Nice.
Thanks to you,
Sparky.
I'm back in business. Here you are. One brand new fully charged Lumina Crystal. She's a beauty. I hope she serves you well.
Alright. Oh. Almost leveled up. Here we go. Oh. Okay. Back to Duncan Grimwater. We should level up from that, which will refill the mana. Hey!
A Lumina Crystal! The Lumina Crystal will boost the power of my ritual. It'll work this time, I'm sure of it. It's working!
Oh, that's so pretty.
Susie, I can see her! But what was that horrifying thing with her?
Oh, that's so pretty.
That's the Harvest Lord. We studied him in class. He's a powerful spirit from the underworld who harvests the souls of the innocent.
It looked like she's in Galvano's tower. That must be where the Harvest Lord is enchanting the storm amulets. Wizard, please free my sister.
Oh, wow. Oh.
I need you to come help me out with something.
Ooh, a spell quest.
Could you come talk to me, please?
Oh, goodness. Okay, we're taking the teleporter over to Galvanost Tower. All right. Let's go defeat the Harvest Lord. If I remember, he's actually like kind of a difficult boss. So I might want to put in a pixie. Just in case. Here we go. This is the first time we have the little dungeon sigils. How cute.
Ah,
he's fire.
I knew a prisoner would draw more. Wait, my dark master warned me about you.
Ha! Imagine the reward he will give me when I present him your very soul.
This gives me very much Halloween Town vibes.
Help!
If that makes any sense to anyone. Because that voice acting gives me, like, Halloween Town. Like, the first two. Just 45. That just means we need to hit kind of high end to knock you out. Oh, well. Great. He'll love to see it. Okay, well, they're both gonna smack me. Oh, thank God. Thank goodness. Ooh, I don't really know if that's gonna kill. I can hope that it kills. Please, 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 please. Oh my gosh. Is it one short? Was it one short? Oh, please. Please tell me it wasn't one short. That's really rude. That's just rude. Make me waste an extra spell. Okay, now I can take another hit. Blade into a fire elf. So I have the one pip heal. Okay, fire snake. Okay, I can take another hit. He has a pretty strong resist, but not, like, too strong. I'll still do another 100 damage to him. Okay, so I think we hit with Ghoul. Alright, got a little bit of health back. Gonna do another 50-ish. Why do I have such high freaking myth resist? Okay. I just need to do about another 100. Yay. Okay, he fizzled. All right. I can do this. Let's just try it again. It can't fizzle twice in a row, right? That big brain.
I am beaten, but my master's grand design is nearly complete. Triton Avenue is doomed.
I know what he's talking about. Meet me outside, wizard. I need your help.
I don't actually remember this part. Hold up. Wait a second. Susie?
I overheard the Harvest Lord's plans. He was raising an army of rotting fodder, armed with
storm magic
to attack Wizard
pretty.
City. But there's more. The Tempest Nexus up on the ridge channels storm energy into Trident Avenue. The Harvest Lord diverted the flow of energy to enchant the amulets. But after he finished the amulets, he directed the flow back on itself. The Nexus will explode and take Trident Avenue with it.
Okay.
Use the teleporter by the mill to reach the Tempest Nexus. I'll meet you up there.
Okay. Yo, how's she gonna get there quicker than me? She didn't even take the teleporter. Is this to the high ledge? Noise. She got here before me.
It's worse than I thought. The Nexus could explode at any moment. The controls, they aren't working. I can't set it right. Professor Bellstrom knows more about storm magic than anyone. Go ask him for help.
You can get to Ravenwood and back quick. Use the Return to Commons button to get back to the Commons, and then head to Ravenwood.
But if I go to my dorm, it puts me right at Ravenwood. Alright, here we go. Booking it to my man, the little frog. Hello, sir.
Hello, wizard! What? The Tempest Nexus is going to explode? Oh, dear me, we can't have that! Here, take this master key, ring it against the metal of the Nexus 3 times, and the feedback loop should end! Good luck, and move quickly!
If you mark your location in Triton Avenue, click the recall button to return to your mark.
Yay. Okay.
You did it, wizard! Triton Avenue is saved!
What can I say?
You didn't happen to run into my little brother Arthur anywhere, did you?
Arthur? I thought it was Arthur.
He's alright? Thank goodness. Take me to him. It'll be good to see him again.
I bet you you'll beat me there. It is Arthur. I thought it was Arthur. All of these years, I thought his name was Arthur. It had to have been at one point. It had to. Arthur, what?
You rescued Susie. All's well. The Harvest Lord has been driven back into the shadows, and the storm energy is flowing again.
There's still a lot of undead roaming around, but without the Harvest Lord to direct them, we can handle them.
I'll help. So, the Harvest Lord said he had a dark master. Track that master down, wizard, so Malastare's memory can be redeemed.
I've got some bad news for you, buddy.
Maybe you should leave that for later. For now, tell Sergeant Muldoon that things are calming down.
Alright. That I can do. Oh, wait. Oh, that's so pretty. Alright, we gotta head on back to Old Town. And that was Triton Avenue. Kind of fun. Should we deal with another jerk next? Because there's another jerk in one of the other streets. He's notorious.
Triton Avenue's not going to explode? Well, I should hope not! Sounds like things are getting sorted out. What a relief. Thanks, wizard.
Woo. Alright.
There's a kid on Cyclops Lane named Nolan Stormgate. You should talk to him. He sounds like he's in trouble. He's dealing with the giants there and has been asking us to send students. Better go see what he wants.
Alright.
One of my guards can't spare any men.
Sure.
But maybe you can help. So he's on Firecat Alley.
We got a little notification that our lovely little professor needs to see us. So let's go see what that's about, and then we will do Cyclops Lane in the next episode. I'm thinking of doing like a street per episode, you know, as one does. Let's see.
I see you're ready to learn pyromancy. If so, you'll need this bloodstone to summon the servants of the dragon.
Falmea hands you a small, perfectly...
Go seek the ancient sanctuary known as the Dragon. When you find the fire within, hold the bloodstone tight and whisper the name of the creature you seek.
Alright, let's go do this. Let's go get a spell. Golem Core is here. Normally, you can't enter this area until, spoiler alert, until Dragon's Fire. And that's when you get to enter this area, but I guess we get to enter it now.
You whisper the name.
Oh, I guess we're not going in.
Peronis.
We hear your call and answer, Pyromancer. You may enter the dragon's mouth.
Yo, that was so cool. That was so cool. Look at it!
In the dancing flames, you see a great battle. It is the War of the Titans. The sky is thick with a cloud of winged dragons. They hurl themselves against the strong, vengeful giants and the sly, wicked tritons. Only one dragon remains. She is old and alone. For centuries, she slumbers. A shadow falls over her. It is a wizard, a figure with eyes of fire and a wicked scowl. The wizard turns, looks at you through the flames, and suddenly the vision is gone.
Dang. They really hit you with that. They really gave Malister a plot in a spell quest. Bit quirky if you do ask me. Alright, what spell we getting? Make it a good one, make it useful.
So, my young student, what did you see in the fire of destiny?
Professor Falmea looks deeply concerned.
As you should.
Oh my, it seems that Wizard City has a powerful enemy. You must practice your lessons immediately. Start with this fire spell. Wizard City may need all the protection it can get.
Yeah, hit me with a convert. Hit me with a convert. Alright, well, I'll end the episode here. Oh my god, look at us. How cute. Look at the fit. Alright, well, I will head off. We will do Cyclops Lane in the next episode. And after that, we got Firecat Alley, and then we're moving on to the next world. So I'll see you guys in the next one.